It's exciting because even though the financial crisis did create a dent in the progress that we have been seeing, there's some structural positive developments that have captivated everybody's imagination. One, we've seen a much more stable financial system from a regulatory perspective. Two, we have seen significant private sector interest in capital going into Africa. But much more visibly, we have seen a lot of developments in terms of technology that is changing the landscape of finance in Africa. That said, when you add up all of these exciting developments, the real challenge we face is that none of them, individually or collectively, creates that dent in terms of job creation that is able to support the private sector in creating the number of jobs that we need to absorb the challenges that Africa has. We are still very far from being able to address the infrastructure gap of $93 billion annually. And so in the work that we've been doing at the bank and certainly this latest publication, the challenge we set ourselves was how do we do three things? One, increase the range of financial services available for basic financial transactions, overdrafts, trade credit, everything that the private sector needs to engage Africa productively. Secondly, how do we increase the availability of long-term finance for growth, for long-term investment? And thirdly, how do we make sure that we don't lose the stability that we've worked hard to attain in Africa? And there's a range of recommendations, there's a range of actions that we certainly look to working with the continent in supporting, but I'll summarize four. The first is to rethink what we mean by competition. It goes much more than simply licensing new financial institutions. What we're trying to see is changing the competitive model so that it becomes much more accommodating of non-bank financial institutions, bringing in telecom companies, going beyond the traditional financial players that we've seen on the continent. The second thing is to make sure that the innovation that comes into the sector is accommodated from a legal and regulatory policy. So working with policymakers so that the public policy stance moves from the traditional, let's create a regulation, let us then encourage the innovation, but turn that on its head and encourage much more innovation and have the regulation follow that so that we don't stifle the opportunities that abound. The second, and perhaps the more relevant one for a lot of the CEOs in this room, I think is improving the environment for long-term finance. And we really have to do this at three levels. The first is to sustain the macro stability that Africa is increasingly enjoying, including the political one. The second is at the institutional level, improve the ecosystem for long-term transactions. And this means more than just focusing on tweaking and shining the Rolls-Royce structures of stock exchanges. It involves having personnel and staff to structure transactions. It means making sure that our cross-border regulations accommodate all of that. And then finally, at the institutional level, making it easier for firms to come into Africa at a regional level to make sure that the markets are substantial and of interest of the type of institutions that my two panelists will speak of. And then finally, in terms of regulation, just making sure that the regulations we design and tailor are not only just suited for commercial banks, but other non-bank financial structures. So there's a plethora of recommendations that we look at, but what really excites me in this current environment is taking advantage of the technology that we are seeing in the continent, the pace of globalization and integration on the continent, and seeing innovative financial institutions take advantage of these new trends to increase the availability of finance, to lengthen the tenure of this finance and make sure that this finance actually works for private sector development on the continent. My 60-second response is simply to acknowledge that Africa has unique sets of challenges in the form of a substantial volume of informality, limited scale, governance, that results in a highly priced banking model, whether it's in the form of interest rates or inability to support SMEs. And that's why when we speak of competition today, the challenge is really competition for the banking model rather than within the banking system itself, bringing more players to the financial system so that we capture the informality and serve them much better than we have. And I'll end by simply saying that you only have to fly into any African city to see the level of construction, the level of of informal trade taking place. If you look at the bank balance sheets, you'll see a disconnect in the terms of the proportion of financial services going to that informal sector. The challenge for all of us is how to develop the products, as both CEOs have started to do, that serve that particular clientele. Thank you.
Doing business in Africa. You can't afford to be without Africa Investor.